It is March 30, 2017, and I'm headed down to the Capitol Beltway in Washington from Shrewsbury, PA, and there's a squirrel. Is that a good sign or what? Just wanted to say that's what I'm going to be doing, and I'm probably going to be cutting this off in a second, because there's no use in wasting video for stuff that's at my house. Just wanted to let you know. I'll probably cut it on when I get past, because I've got a million videos of, you know, going around Baltimore 695 and all that stuff, so who cares? So I'll probably see you on Interstate 95 when I get close. See you then. Guys, we are on Interstate 95 right now. And we're getting close to where we're going to be crossing, right under my old room where I used to live. It's going to be Montgomery Road, and I'm up there, I'm off on the left lane. So let's see what happens. Wow, they built more walls there. Keep the highways quiet. Like we're here. Like if you get this bridge coming up, if you go to the left, I used to walk across this bridge. Montgomery Road and Howard Counters. Up bridge. And to the left over the wall, I used to walk right on this road that's right on the other side of the wall to on the left of the highway. Used to go for walks. Kind of interesting, maybe. It's backed up on the other side of the road already. Already. It's incredible, man. This place is just nothing but traffic all the time. Basically, my task today is to I need my security badge so that I can do work for the United States government. So that's what I'm down here for. 67 miles one way. I think it's 67 to 70 miles. We'll know. I've done about 50 or so already. Wow, it looks like there's a plane in the sky. If you can see it, it looks like it's practically sitting still, but it's not really. It's moving fast. What the hell? It seems like it's not even moving. Is that a real plane? Yes, it is. Oh, it's landing. Gotta tell you, this traffic blows.
Just like this Soviet ambassador and anybody else were totally legal. And those people talk to Americans who are not under surveillance. And that's where the problem comes in. When you unmask Americans not under surveillance and leak with those Americans, then when you don't have a wiretap to do so, the clear violation of law. But the actual collection of the evidence that the surveillance was legal. Anyway, there's no reason for Nunes to recuse himself. The Democrats are playing pure obstructionism here because this is the only thing that they have to try to taint the election and the Trump, actually not the election, not the Trump presidency. Now let's move on here to Evelyn Farkas, a former Obama administration official. She has let the cat out of the bag. And if anybody needs to be called to testify, it's Evelyn Farkas. In case you haven't heard by now, Ms. Evelyn Farkas. You've got to be real careful on radio pronouncing that name. and I'm just exercising extreme caution here.
Go ahead, dude.
Evelyn Park is an Obama Pentagon Russian expert who told Mika Brzezinski on PMSNBC a couple of days ago that the regime, the Obama regime, was
and PMS
collecting
in the same radio
intelligence on the Trump campaign. And she said that they were unmasking the Trump people and leaking that info to the media. And that her only concern was that the administration and the Hill, Capitol Hill, would not be able to protect the sources and methods from the Trump people, the Trump agenda. She
admitted all of this. The Hill's
flying out of that. She may have outed herself as the source for all of this that ran on CNN and in the New York Times. And it's clear why she did it. She is a tunnel-visioned ideologue. And she went on MSNBC, where she's surrounded in her mind by like-minded people who would have done the same thing had they been her, and who are willing and waiting to applaud her for doing it. She forgot that MSNBC has an audience, and who can blame her for that? It's widely known that MSNBC does not have an audience. So she, for all intents and purposes, thought she was in a bar with some of her friends at like 6:30, 7 o'clock in the morning, and that nobody was listening. There. And she was talking to a bunch of like-minded
Something all over the room. Someone's coming out of a truck somewhere or something.
That's why it was so important for the intelligence to be widely distributed, as it was. She left the Obama administration
from
the Pentagon in September 2015. So,
here's an oversized load.
Contrary to it meaning that she was out the loop,
bigger in size than it's supposed to be.
It means that this intel collection against the Trump campaign had to be going on from the very early days. Remember, Trump's trip down the escalator was in June of 2016, or was it July? June 16th, and that trip down the escalator. June of 2015, and Evelyn Park said that the intelligence collection, the surveillance against the Trump campaign, says she left in September 2015 and she knew about it, and it had to be going on in the summer of 2015, which in and of itself is quite amazing. It's earth-shattering, it's blockbuster, given that scarcely anyone gave Trump a chance of getting the nomination. Remember, this is the period of time, I mean, it comes June the 16th announcement, that's where everybody was laughing
and stuff, so
they couldn't possibly be serious. He's just come out here and basically called every Mexican a rapist, said he doesn't respect McCain because he doesn't like military people that get captured, he doesn't respect all that. And this is back in the days when people thought Trump was going to implode and crater with every public appearance. And that went on for 2 or 3 months. They were not taking Trump seriously. That's what's amazing about this. They were still surveilling the guy. According in his campaign, according to Evelyn Farkas. Now, Comey told us the Russians only wanted to see Hillary get defeated. And that's another thing. How's that intel? But last week at that vaunted Capitol Hill hearing, for the House Intelligence Committee, Comey, and oh yeah, the Russians wanted Hillary defeated. So why weren't the Russians colluding with Jeb? I mean, everybody back then thought Jeb was going to be the nominee. Is that not true? Why would anybody be colluding with Trump? Nobody thought Trump was going to win. Probably Trump didn't think he was going to win. Although, he says he did, but June, July, August, 2015. That's, folks, we're coming up on a year and a half ago now. And at that time, everybody thought it was going to be Jeb. Everybody thought it was going to be Jeb. Am I right about that? And there was some attention being paid to Ted Cruz, but not Trump. So why weren't the Russians trying to engineer some deal with Jeb? Why is there any intel on that? Why weren't the Russians trying to strike a deal with Cruz? Why isn't there any intel on that? Why haven't there been any leaks about that? Because nobody in 2015 thought that it was going to be the Trumpster. Let's listen to Evelyn Farkas. We have the audio sound bites here from March. Yeah, but I know that's right. I thought this was much more recent than that. We'll just say recently, and then she was on Squawk Box today. So here's the first bite. This is March 2nd. It was on the Mississippi Morning Joe. And they were discussing allegations that the Obama administration conducting surveillance of the Trump transition team. This is, again, Evelyn Farkas.
I was urging my former colleagues and, frankly speaking, the people on the Hill, it was more actually aimed at telling the Hill people, get as much information as you can, get as much intelligence as you can before President Obama leaves the administration, because I had a fear that somehow that information would disappear with the senior people who left. So it would be hidden away in the bureaucracy, that the Trump folks, if they found out how we knew what we knew about the Trump staff dealing with Russians, that they would try to compromise those sources and methods, meaning we would no longer have access to that intelligence. So I became very worried because not enough was coming out into the open, and I knew that there was more. We have very good intelligence on Russia. So then I had talked to some of my former colleagues, and I knew that they were trying to also help get information to the Hill. That's why you have the leaking.
She admits it. It was right there. She admitted that they were collecting it, preserving it, and then urging people to get it out. In her words, get it to the Hill, meaning Democrats on the Hill, before the Obama administration left. And we've had stories right there in I guess it was the New York Times, Obama ordered people to preserve all the intelligence being gathered, which has led many people, including moi, to ask, what do you mean preserve the intelligence being gathered? I thought there wasn't any intelligence being gathered. I thought Trump was not being surveilled. Of course he was. We've known this from the first story saying whatever it said with the sources being intelligence operatives deep inside the intelligence community. The New York Times and all those stories talking about intercepts, and
damn,
the one
man
on January 20th talking about wiretaps. Where were they getting all this?
Now this guy's going really slow.
Somebody had to be leaking it to them, and somebody had to be collecting it. And this woman, Evelyn Park, just caught to it.
You gotta love that name, Evelyn Farkas.
And you have to ask, what, does she realize what she's doing?
I wonder what his name is. Dick Farkas?
My name's Dick Farkas,
and this is my wife, Evelyn Farkas.
Understanding and sympathetic.
We're the Farkases.
Supportive.
Meet the Farkases.
She hadn't the slightest compunction about this. I was urging my former colleague, and frankly speaking, the people on the Hill. It was more actually aimed at telling the Hill people, get as much information as you can. Get as much intelligence as you can before Obama leaves, because I had a fear that somehow that information would disappear with the senior people who left, so it would be hidden away in the bureaucracy. If they found out how we knew what we knew about Trump staff dealing with Russians, they would try to compromise those sources and methods, meaning we would no longer have access to the intelligence. So I became very worried because not enough was coming out into the open, and I knew there was more. We have very good intelligence on Russia. So then I had talked to some of my former colleagues, and I knew that they were trying to get information to the Hill. That's why you have leaking. This woman needs to be brought up and testify right now. This woman outed herself.
Here we are, Capitol Beltway.
And who knows whoever else.
I am going
admitting that they were preserving it, admitting they were afraid that if it wasn't used, that the Trump people would bury it when they were sworn in.
Damn, it only took an hour.
So they had to get it out because the intelligence was very good. She was worried because not enough was coming out. She talked to some of her former colleagues, And after that, knew that they were trying to also get information to the Hill. That's why you have the leaking. Do you know that this story, Evelyn Farkas, appearance on MSNBC, has yet to be reported on CNN, the New York Times, the Washington Post? It remains an unknown story to Americans who only get their news from the drive-by media.
Rush Farkas.
On the EIB network. Rush Limbaugh on WCBS.
Okay, I want to get over, bitch. I mean, nice.
You're getting your land ready for spring. You need
a
tractor.
Not even a lady, so.
But how do you know if you're buying the right tractor? Well, talk to somebody who already has one, like the 98% of Mahindra owners who would recommend a Mahindra to their friends. That's right, folks, 98%. Mahindra stands behind their tractors and utility vehicles with the industry's leading warranty.
They're made like being to in the last Washington,
with real
D.C.
steel,
suburbs.
Not plastic.
When you live in Pennsylvania.
Utility vehicles are even built right here in the U.S.
It took 1 hour to get down
trust
here.
Your land to the toughest tractors and utility vehicles on Earth,
but,
and you'll discover why Mahindra is the world's number one selling tractor.
Do what I came to do, so I can get up the road before the traffic starts again.
MahindraUSA.com.
Take advantage of rock-bottom prices and test drive a Mahindra today at Eastern Shore Tractor in Accomack. Or visit EasternShoreTractor.com. That's EasternShoreTractor.com.
When was the last time you watched your home movies? If you're like most Americans, there's a box in your closet of videotapes, film reels, and photos that don't get watched. Worse, they're wasting away. Introducing Legacy Box, a simple and affordable way to get your recorded moments digitally preserved on DVD or thumb drive. Here's how it works. Load Legacy Box with your old tapes, film, pictures, and audio recordings, and send it back. You'll get them back in a couple of weeks on DVD or convenient thumb drive, ready to watch, share, and relive. Legacy Box takes care of everything and provides updates at every step of the process. That's why over 250,000 families have used them. The Huffington Post, Parents Magazine, USA Today, and The View are all talking about Legacy Box. Because Legacy Box...
It's been a long time since I've been down here.
And for a limited
6 years to be in this one spot coming up. This is where I got my clearance to work at the Housing and Urban Development.
LegacyBox.com/talkradio.
It's been 6 years since I've been to this place. You would think that they could just use what they had, but no, they gotta make you do it again and again. This will be the second time I've had my fingerprints taken. One was for clear to be cleared, cleared. Oh, so there's a guy. There's a cop sitting at that empty house. Interesting. Anyway. I had to take fingerprints to get clear. I did that up in Pennsylvania at a police station in Jacoby. It took me 3 hours because I had to wait for other people. And now I have to come down to Washington because this is the one for the actual government agency. And guess what they want to do? Take my picture, fingerprints again. They can't just get the fingerprints from the other place, from there, which was clear. But now I have to have an additional set of fingerprints, which is totally unfreaking believable. Wow, Prince George's Avenue. I used to live on Prince George's Street, but that is way far away from Catesville. These are all named after the counties, just like Catesville Manor. Hartford Avenue.
These systems are on the top of the line in quality and dependability, just like Perry Hall Heating and Air Conditioning. Call 410-256-7285 for a free, no-pressure estimate.
Let's just keep going, Power Mill. I'm not going to take deviate.
What's your reason?
I know if I made it right, it would take me where I gotta go.
Celebrating their 35th year of serving.
Stained glass. Call 937-4437. I don't want stains on my glass. I want a glass that I can see through. I mean, I don't want to have to break out the Windex and bleach just to get that off when I get it. Stained glass. That's like saying stained sheets.
I can prove my contention. 1 mile ahead. Nobody watches MSNBC because I double checked here. And Evelyn Farkas did appear on MSNBC on March 2nd or March 3rd. It is March.
Hurry up.
28th to start.
It's 1:24, man. I got an hour and 15 minutes, so I'm going to have lunch somewhere, and then I got to go get this done.
Nobody watches MSNBC. If it took 3 weeks for this statement of hers to go public.
Come on, man. Oh, it's a red light. I guess you can't.
Substance watches MSNBC. They would have spotted that the moment they heard it.
Damn. Look at all the trash everywhere. God, they don't.
People didn't even realize what they'd heard.
Okay, so it's red. It's red. We can make a right on red because, oh my God, look at the traffic down here. Holy sheep shit.
It's a pleasure talking to you. I've been listening to you for a long time.
Computer tech. Beltsville Plaza.
Going, attacking the Freedom Caucus. I just have this to say.
Farkas, Caucus,
voters voted for
PMS. Gosh, they've done them all in here.
The rum-dum Republicans or Hillary. So what was left? Donald Trump. So we all jumped on the bandwagon. We think here's our conservative guy. He's going to lead us out of the woods. Maybe America can't get green again. And what is he going to do the first time he gets the big bill? They do a crappy job on it. It turns out nobody likes it. It's bad for America, not good for America. It's kind of like state health care. Under Trump, he should thank the conservative
Boy Caucus for saving
Boy King. King.
Guys, look at the traffic on this road, man. This is Route 1, by the way. If I turned around and went the opposite direction, in about 20 minutes, I could be where I used to live on Rumbleberry Drive in Elkridge. This is Washington Boulevard. Of course, when you get up a certain distance, out of PG, they call it Baltimore Avenue.
And now it looks like
this is ridiculous, man. Jeez, man, what the
out.
Flying?
You can't even understand the Freedom Caucus is his ticket to rise to success. I just
Shit.
Don't.
We're all
we
stuck.
Want good government. We don't want fake government. And he's got our backing only if he knows
Go
how
ahead,
to
man.
Make America great again.
We will
not giving up.
I lost myself. Either my batteries that are connections loose.
Option.
Yeah, Jim. Let me step in here. Because I know what you're reacting to. Mm-hmm. I made a statement in the first segment of the program today when talking about how the president says he's going to reach out to the Democrats. He tweeted out.
Shit, I'm going to have to go. I'm going to have to go through it.
Or he's going to campaign against 2018. They better next time they better get in gear, or it's over for them. And I opined at the time that there are some.
I hope that it didn't. Oh man.
Who are going to stick with him on this?
This is confusing. I got stuck right in the middle of a red light. I hope that doesn't end up being a ticket. I really do.
I said not everybody.
Although, oh, fuck. Shit, there are cameras. There's no cameras on this one, but there's cameras on that one.
He's one of these people.
I tell you, if I get a ticket, man, I'm going to be pissed. Because I got stuck. I got left out in the cold. But because nobody, they all stopped. It's not my fault. And you know what they'll do? They'll make you come all the way down here to go to court for the ticket. Yeah. God, this traffic is horrible. I'm going to check out a place called Yaya's Kitchen. If I can ever get to it, because the traffic is horrible here. I hope that I don't get a ticket for that. I'm going to be pissed. Because I was stuck in the middle of the red light, and there was nothing I could do about it. So. There's Arby's. It's ridiculous.
Reaching out to the Democrats.
Well, it says I left with 886 on there, and it says 951.
In the House,
so that's about close
to
accurate, pretty much.
Done, he will. And I know what you're saying. You're not one of those voters that's going to hang with Trump no matter what.
I gotta.
I get that.
Make a pit stop and eat.
Every Trump voter.
So here we are.
Would hang with Trump in this circumstance.
I will be back in
but
a little
some
bit.
Of them will, folks. I'm just telling
Maybe
you.
Maybe we'll film a little bit going home.
Some people voted.
I'll probably film going to the building because that'll be kind
of
cool.
And
but
had plenty of chances to
I'll see you guys in a little bit.
Later.
There it is. Yaya's. Yaya's Kitchen. The best gyros in the area. It's Greek food, and I would have to say, yeah, they've got so much in there. I had some kind of lamb something 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 gyros with some fries, and it was good. It's right off of Route 1 in Beltsville, in case you ever want to go. It's across from the Arby's, but it's a very good, it's not a bad place to eat. Pretty cool. But I've got to get, well, I got some time, but I'm going to put myself back in the driver's thing. There you go. Back in there. We're back safe and sound in our little holder here. Okay, so I got to loosen a little bit. There we go. So it's even. There you go. And we're going to head on over to where the security clearance is done. It's an interesting day. I mean, coming from all the way Shrewsbury, PA, which is kind of far from Washington, D.C. Coming down here to do this. But we got to get her done. Get her done. All right. I still have lots of time. I think it's only a little after 2. Appointments for 2:45 to get it done. And it is... Damn, it's not even 2 o'clock yet. I gotta wait. Damn.
One thing.
Damn, so there's... Here comes some women. They were talking a lot. Boy, they was talking. Talky, talky, talky. Oh, man. So I'm going over the curb. Oh, shit. They was talking, these women right there. They were talking like you wouldn't believe. The one in the purple, mainly. The other one was kind of listening. But it's legal. Okay, yep, make it right. Go on. Oh, go ahead, come on. That's it, just cut right in there. Just don't worry about it. Just come right in. Do what you gotta do anytime you feel like it. I don't know if I can make a left here. Oh, my loving God. You'll never make a left here, but that's where I have to go. I'm going to go up and I'm going to make a right and then come back and make a left. I mean, you know, I'll never get out of here. Oh, man, I could have went if this bus. Son of a. Come on, man. Oh, I could have went right there and watched the blinker come on. Somebody, nobody's waiting behind me. Look, there's nobody. Oh, there's nobody coming. Wow. Should have used a blinky, but I wasn't sure if I was going to go left or right, man. Hey, this is where I'm going, Sunnyside Avenue. And there's no sun out. Not even a little. I hope I don't get a ticket for that one. Like, that's going to suck. I couldn't help it. I got stuck in the middle of it. What was I supposed to do? Come on, man. See, these people making this turn here. What the fuck? Go, man. You're holding everybody up. Yeah, this is all I need is to get stuck. Okay. Yeah, let me get out of here. I don't want to get stuck in another one. Yeah, I got a feeling because I know how Washington, D.C. is. They'll give you a ticket. They'll give you a ticket any shot, any chance in hell that they have to give you one. They'll do it. Cowles, S82229, cowlsauto.com, Rhode Island Avenue. It's always people right up your ass too. So if you're looking for a place, you got problems because they're right, literally up your ass. Here, I'm not sure. Like right here. What? Oh, that's not it. That's not it. That is it. That's it. God damn it. I I mean, gosh darn it. That was where I needed to go, and I didn't go. It's hard to tell, man. You can't see it. Let's see if I can get in here. Mm-hmm. Oh, there's duckies, look. Look, there's little duckies. Oh, they're everywhere. Yeah, there's the building right there. I won't film inside the building because I don't think they would appreciate that. You're coming in here for a clearance and, well, see how that works. Always, yet, guess what? Yet another person is up my fucking ass. And he's on his cell phone. I thought that was illegal in the state of Maryland. He's talking on his phone. I don't have any hands on my phone. It's in a, what do you call it? It's attached to a holder. But that's where I gotta have to go in front of that thing. And so is he still following me? Because I'm gonna get annoyed. See, I parked right over here last time and walked around. You don't have to, but I did. It's funny how I was gonna, see, I just made a complete U-turn because I could have came right in where this guy's coming in. That would have been that. I want to park here because this is where I parked before. Right here. There's somebody's house. And there it is. Well, all right. We're over here. At the end of this video, I will make a little map, or at the beginning, or wherever, beginning or end, somewhere in there, I will make it so that we have a, what do you call it? I'll show you the map location of this place. There's cameras everywhere. Look, there's a camera over there. Reserve shot slot. Shuttle vehicles only. Well, I guess I'm getting out of here then. That's what it says. I don't trust it. I'm going to go down here where it ain't reserved for shuttle crafts or whatever the hell it is. Let's park over here. I parked there the last time and nothing happened, but it's maybe I guess I got lucky. All right, you have, gosh, I got 40 minutes. 40 minutes to go. 40 minutes to go. Man, this thing shouldn't be, yeah, it should be like this. Well, all it does is get the dash when you do that, so screw it. All right, people. I think what I'm going to do since I have time is maybe give Mom a call real quick. Say hello from Washington, D.C., and then I will be back when I come out. We will turn it on. You will see this view again when I come out. You will see this again, okay? Only it will be probably like 20, 30 minutes have passed. But I will not be bullshitting around when I get out of here because if I don't get up the highway and get around Baltimore and north of Baltimore towards Hunt Valley on 83, if I don't get there by 5 o'clock, I'm in trouble because the traffic will just add another hour to your time. Anyway, I will be back in a little while. See ya from Sunnyside Avenue, Beltsville, Maryland. I am back. I am outside the building and I'm getting ready to leave. Had to get all the prints done. Everything's done and I'm ready to go home. I said it was like 8:80. Let's see. Well, let me get my damn. So there's a guy. He's getting out. He's like, man, I gotta go to works. And I'm like, well, I don't gotta works. I gotta go homes. Okay, so it is 3:22. Holy shit! Gotta get up the highway before the traffic. I had 55,886 miles when I left my house. I now have 55,952 miles. So you do the math. It's a long drive, and I gotta get going before the highway gets backed up, so stay away from me now. Here we go. Alright, ready? We're gonna get out of Dodge. We're gonna get out of... I'm gonna drive past the front of the building just so in case anybody wants to seize what it looks like. This is the USDA right here, and among other things. This is where people go to get clearances for all kinds of buildings. I could have went to the Treasury building in Baltimore, but it's a nightmare going through all that crap that you got to go through with downtown parking, everything else. And here's the front of the building. So it says slow down 15 miles an hour. Am I bold enough to do a circle around the front of this building? I think I am. Doesn't say I can't enter. I'm going to do a little circle so people can see what the front of this building looks like. There it is. And wow, there's some ladies coming out. And that's it. Guy on the phone, very attractive. Not. Keep right. So let's get out of here. What I am going to do is the Baltimore Beltway. I mean, not the Baltimore Beltway. I'm going to go right down to the Capitol Beltway and then around and go up 95 instead of going all those side streets we did. Because the Capitol Beltway is like right here. So let's get her done. So I stepped in some soda or something. My right foot, my shoe, it just keeps sticking. Like, it's got sticky soda on it. Columbia Rubber Corporation. And then there's J.E. Richards. Not J.J. Richards, but J.E. Richards Contractors. Look, conveyor belts. There we go. Look at all that property. Well, you probably can't see it to the left. But there's a lot of property. We are now at Rhode Island Avenue for cheeseburger. Nah, no cheeseburgers. Here we go. That's rock and roll, man. Oh man, I think I have to get over to this other lane. This guy is not gonna let me do it, you motherfucker. I think I have to probably, because I want to get on the highway, I'm gonna have to get over to the lane. I know it. Coming up, I guarantee you. Maryland Inspections Station. Rising Sun Motors, Maryland. Rising Sun is Delaware, you dumbass. Come on, man, Mr. Facebook. Hurry up. God damn, get away. Beltsville Agricultural Research Center. That's it. God, that's a big building. Looks like a, probably was a mansion at one point. Who knows? See, it's much quicker just to, so you get every light. Every light you can get's gotta happen. Once I get on this highway, I don't have to get off the highway until I'm pretty much in Pennsylvania. I don't have to stop. So let's go. If this Mr. First in Flight North Carolina truck would go. City of College Park, welcome. I'll be saying goodbye to it really quick. Buffalo Wild Wings. Holiday Inn. Wow, this looks deserted or something. Up there. God, come on. Everybody's got to make a friggin' turn somewhere. God. Let me get on the highway. It's at some point in my life. Okay, you don't go there. You go here. All right, here we go. Finally. Because if I kept going on Route 1, University of Maryland, if I'd have kept going straight, that's where it is. Been there. If Dave is actually watching this, David Shishler, he knows. We have spent many a time doing cables. University of Maryland. Because this is Prince George's counter. Okay, get over here. Get ready to go to 95 North. We are on the Capitol Beltway in Baltimore, briefly. I mean, in the Capitol Beltway in Washington. Here we go. We're going to zip right past Baltimore and go all the way to Pennsylvania. Is it with the people I get stuck behind? Come on, man. Drive better. Use your blinker. Now, it is 3:30. If I can get to the Baltimore Beltway and around that sucker, 4 or 5 o'clock, I'm probably going to be okay. But something tells me it's not going to happen. Because we're already backing up, already. Looks like some road rage is getting ready to happen. This guy's brake checking the other guy. Hey, don't get in front of me, geez. Man, in about an hour, this is going to be a parking lot. I'm telling you, you're not going to be moving but a few feet at a time, so must get out of here. I'm in a rush to get out of here, for sure.
Weekend at the Frederick County Fairgrounds. I'm Jim Lavin for Talk Radio 680 WCBM.
Clouds have already rolled in, and we're going to keep the clouds in the forecast here through the afternoon at 53. Showers likely overnight tonight, low 42. Rain and thunderstorms a good bet tomorrow. Some of the rain could be heavy, high 60. Clouds on tap for Saturday, high 62. Richard Weddick and the Weather Channel for Talk Radio 680 WCBM. Now, keeping Talk Radio 680 WCBM and WCBM.com.
Good afternoon. I'm Michael Filippelli in the 680 WCBM Maryland News Center with the news at 3:31. Stock index is climbing today, buoyed by gains in shares of financial companies. Stocks have largely bounced back since last Friday, when they posted their biggest weekly drop in months. 30 minutes before the closing bell, the Dow Jones Industrial Average climbing 75 points to 20,734. The Standard & Poor's 500 Index up 7 points, and the Nasdaq Composite has gained 17. A bill rolling back North Carolina's contentious LGBT bathroom bill has passed the General Assembly and is now headed to the governor's desk. Democrat Governor Roy Cooper has said he supports the measure. An expert said Russian-directed disinformation campaigns targeted all the Republican presidential candidates.
During a hearing on Russian meddling in the election, Clint Watts of the Foreign Policy Research Institute told Senator Marco Rubio that his presidential campaign was targeted. Right now at the Inner Harbor in downtown Baltimore, it's 50 degrees, 48 degrees at BWI Thurgood Marshall Airport. Reporting at 3:32, I'm Michael Filippelli, 680 WCBM News.
Hi, I'm attorney Stephen Friedman. As many of you know, the law offices of Michael Friedman have been representing injured victims of auto accidents and other negligent acts for over 35 years. Over the years, we have learned that what really matters to our clients is getting back to health and resuming their lives. Our goal was to handle the obstacles that might prevent or slow down the recovery process, such as arranging for auto repairs, obtaining a car rental, assuring the best medical care, and handling any other immediate concerns that any person or family faces after a serious accident. Of course, at the end of the day, our responsibility is to obtain a fair and just monetary award that will compensate our clients for the injury and pain and suffering sustained. So if you or a loved one have been injured in an auto accident or by any negligent act, please call us for a free consultation at 410-363-6848. The law offices of Michael Friedman, serving the Mid-Atlantic region for over 35 years.
We couldn't let deals this good pass you by, so we've extended the end of quarter clearance sale at Lumber Liquidators. Get unbeatable deals in more than 40 million square feet of beautiful top quality floors, like 5-inch white pre-finished gun stock oak for just $149, and more than 230 other styles of pre-finished hardwood up to 35% off, 55 styles of North American and European laminate up to 31% off,
so
plus
good.
More from $59.
Fucking stupid commercials, man. Come on.
Clearance sale ends Friday at Lumber Liquidators. MedStar Union Memorial Hospital is the first and only orthopedic program in the entire state of Maryland to offer Makoplasty robotic total knee replacement. It's a better fit, personalized just for you.
This morning, I used my new knee to go for a pain-free stroll. And if you'll excuse me, I'm about to use my new knee to bowl another strike.
To learn more about the advanced treatment options we offer, visit MedStarOrtho.org/MAKO.
We have a silent coup attempt going on here.
If you are not angry yet.
And clowns on Capitol Hill that call themselves Republicans. That's so stupid, they're joining in the fight.
Wait till you spend some time with this show.
This was set up early on.
Mark Levine.
Entire coordination effort going on here by the fifth column. This isn't a conspiracy. I got this from the New York Times and earlier the Washington Post. Are they in on the conspiracy?
Mark Levin, weeknights at 7, coaching 3-1 on Talk Radio 680, WCBM.
This is the 50,000-watt beacon of freedom, Talk Radio 680, WCBM.
As the solution, if you will. Because look, I can rant and rave and be angry all I want here. It's not going to solve the problem. There's no other choice for the Republicans. They've got to keep their promises. Now, to his credit, up to this point, the president is checking off his list. He did a lot this week by moving forward with energy independence and getting rid of burdensome regulation. And he's doing pretty much everything he can do on his own. He's got the wheel in motion for the wall, the wheel in motion for refugees, the wheel in motion. They're beginning to put together a budget bill. By the way, and a problem with the budget bill is they're counting on the savings from the health care bill for the budget, which is now problematic.
Here we go.
And to be handled, as I said, from the beginning. That is, you got to build consensus, you got to get everybody on board, then you unveil the bill, then the president signs it, and then boom, you move ahead, you get the victory. And more importantly, it's not about their victory, it's about undoing the mess that they were sent there to undo. And I get it, I understand there are different competing factions at times, but everybody is going to have to understand that that's part of governing. And then bringing those coalitions together, that is their job in the legislative branch. And by doing this, they sent the president out there doing a lot of heavy lifting. And this is a guy that is used to a business environment where he's the boss and what he says goes. And Washington just doesn't work that way. Now, the president showed an incredible growth trajectory as a candidate, evolved and grew and learned quickly, better than anybody I've ever seen, frankly, as a non-politician. I think it's going to be a little tougher transition getting to the point where you understand you've got 535 egomaniacs that all think they are the most important people in the room. They're not. It's actually the people that they serve that are the really important people. There's a guy in radio, his name is Randy Michaels, and for years he was the chairman of J-Corps, then became Clear Channel, and which, by the way, is the umbrella of the syndication group that runs my show, Rush's show, etc. Anyway, so Randy Michaels years ago, and he's a very interesting guy. He's very bright, very smart, crazy, funny guy. And I remember when I first got hired in Atlanta, I went to a lunch or a dinner with him and Sluggo, who was the PD at the station, was at in Atlanta. At the time.
16 minutes anyway, so far, he used to use this model. Dan.
And I think this is how politicians ought to look at the model. And he'd put up on either a PowerPoint or put up on a chalkboard a pyramid. Now, who's at the top of the pyramid? Who are the people in government that should be at the top of the pyramid? Well, think about it. Who would you put at the top of your pyramid when it comes to governing in Washington or the broader picture of governing in Washington? Well, he would put up at the top of the pyramid the listener. And then he put below, right next to that, is the person closest to the listener, either a disc jockey, a morning show host, a radio talk show host, or a newsman, because they are most closely connected with serving the listener. And then all the way at the bottom of the pyramid, at the base of the pyramid, would be the top management people. And the top management people, their job is to prop up the salespeople, and their job is to prop up the program director, and their job is to prop up the marketing director, which then works to help the talent serve the audience at the top of the pyramid. Well, if you really think about it, at the top of the government pyramid should be you, the American people, and you're the ones that are to be served. And right below you, the people, I guess you probably put next is your congressman and senator. But probably them. And then everybody else, their job is to serve the people. And every bit of energy should be funneled towards the top of that pyramid, propping up that you give the people the best service you possibly can. And for the Republican Party right now, that would mean that they've got to get the best health care bill, dealing with the obvious challenges, both in the Senate, reconciliation, Byrd rule, cloture, etc., and dealing with the varying factions that exist in both the Democratic and Republican Party. Now, in the Republican Party, that's a coalition of moderates, a coalition of Freedom Caucus members and study group members and Tuesday group members and every other group that they have, and getting them all in a room and getting them on board. Also, looping in so it doesn't have to be such a drawn out process and keep starting all over again. You might want to loop in the Senate so that they are very well aware of what you're doing in the House, so that by the time the House passes their bill and the Senate passes their bill and then you go to conference, that there's not going to be so much contention in the room that now you got to start all over again. And after 7-8 years of promising the American people this, they've screwed it up, and it's my job to hold them accountable. Because my job is to also, I'm on the pyramid too, is to serve you with the truth. If they do something good, I'll tell you. If they don't, I'll tell you that too. And there's a simple way to fix this. Solve the problem. Do what they should have done in the beginning. And if that would mean bring the varying coalitions together, work with the Senate, work with the White House, get the bill passed.
Good, man.
Not a perfect bill, because there's no such thing as a perfect bill. And get a bill that's going to repeal and replace Obamacare, and then you can move on to the economy. Then you can move on to economic growth. Then you can move on to tax cuts. Then you can move on to repatriation. Then you can move on to changing the tax code and eliminating the death tax and seven brackets to three and all the other things that we talked at length about. President Trump, what he put on energy. President's doing what he can do on the economy.
Next time
picking
your
up the phone and he's calling all these corporations and saying that things are going
to
change. But we can't get to the economy until we get this healthcare thing done. Get it done. Solve the problem. Solve the problem. My patience is wearing thin. It really is. Because the people that should be getting served here at the top of the pyramid are you. And you're not being served because these egomaniacs can't get their act together and they're unveiling bills that nobody gets a chance to read. That is so dumb. They set themselves up for failure. And they send the president out there to do all their heavy lifting. And that includes twisting arms and telling people to do this and do that. And then he's getting pissed off because people weren't prepared for the bill. As if this is their fault. It's not. And I'm sure a lot of people are throwing blame all across the board. The answer is solve the problem. Solve the problem. Find the solution. All right, let me move on. So yesterday we talked at length about Evelyn Farkas. And let's go back to her take. She says, and I want to play this for you. She was on Liberal Morning Joe March 3rd. Nobody picked up on it. I think because nobody watches the show. Anyway, yeah. Somebody, I guess, was watching a back episode or something. Anyway, so they picked it up yesterday. It becomes big news. She makes the statement. Now, she is no longer, she was working as a deputy associate or assistant deputy, whatever, for the Defense Department from 2012 to 2015. And so how she had access to this information, because at the time she was supporting Hillary and her campaign, and it was reported that she was going to get a job if Hillary had won the election. Anyway, she goes out there to admit. I go back to the four words I mentioned yesterday. One is surveillance. She acknowledges she knew about surveillance of Donald Trump and his transition team. And when he talks about the
See,
Trump
vote,
you know, if they found out that we knew what we knew
right
about there, the Trump staff, and they're dealing with Russia, so she's acknowledging surveillance, she's acknowledging unmasking. And then she's urging her former colleagues and people on the Hill to get that information out as fast as you can. Then she's talking about intel leaks. Listen to her original statement, because she went on TV again today.
I was urging my former colleagues and frankly speaking, the people on the Hill. Mm-hmm. It was more actually aimed at telling the Hill people, get as much information as you can, get as much intelligence as you can before President Obama leaves the administration, because I had a fear that somehow that information would disappear with the senior people who left. So it would be hidden away in the bureaucracy, that the Trump folks, if they found out how we knew what we knew about the Trump staff dealing with Russians, that they would try to compromise those sources and methods, meaning we would no longer have access to that intelligence. So I became very worried because not enough was coming out into the open, and I knew that there was more. We have very good intelligence on Russia. So then I had talked to some of my former colleagues, and I knew that they were trying to also help get information to the Hill.
A lot going on today.
Yeah.
Mark,
that's why you have the leaking.
Exactly. That went right over the head of whatever is such a cute couple, Mika, whatever her name is. All right. But putting that aside here, wow, what a damning admission on Evelyn Farkas's part. Now, because it has to do with surveillance, because it's at a time she may not even have a top security clearance because she's no longer with the Obama administration, and she's admitting that she knows there's surveillance, knows there's intelligence, knows there's unmasking, and is urging the intel to be spread. She's got herself, in my opinion, and I can't say for sure, in one hell of a pickle for herself. Which is why yesterday I was messing around saying, Elizabeth Tucker, I am not a lawyer, but you may want to consult one as soon as possible. Not saying she broke any laws, but I'm saying she may want to consult the lawyer. Now, apparently she didn't take my advice because now she's actually denying that she had access to the surveillance that she said on the tape you just heard and that data. Now, listen to her try to backtrack this as they mentioned me bringing this to the forefront of the national discussion. Listen to this.
And that the Trump folks, if they found out how we knew what we knew about the Trump staff that is dealing with the Russians, that they would try to compromise those sources and methods, meaning we no longer have access to that intelligence. Sean Hannity and others have made a big issue of this. I wanted you to just explain what you meant by that, and in particular, when you talked about if they found out how we knew. What do you mean by how they knew?
Well, what I was getting at was the fact that we were having now a transition of power from the Obama administration to the Trump administration. And if indeed there was an investigation ongoing, if indeed there was information that the Obama administration had about Russian interference and possible American involvement, I wanted to make sure that Congress knew about it, that Congress had all that information. So I simply was referring, because we were having a conversation about concern in Washington about what was going on with regard to Russian actions and potential American involvement. And so I was urging my former colleagues I worked on the Hill in the Senate years ago to make sure that they were reaching out to the White House to get all the information they could, because I was afraid that somehow there might be a cover-up if there was something behind the allegations.
And you actually said, I knew that there was more. I became very worried because not enough was coming out into the open, and I knew that there was more, and then you actually then said that's why you have all the leaking to make sure we get it out. I mean, people are accusing you, Evelyn, of admitting that there was surveillance, admitting that there was unmasking, and urging people, or at least saying that intelligence leaking, which could be a belt, is the way that it should sound. And you weren't even part of the government at that point.
Yeah, so I was referring to the motivation, because there's been a lot of discussion in the media about why are people leaking. And so I was trying to, but in a very short fashion, explain at the very end of that quote.
All right, because I'm running out of time. She is directly contradicting.
Yep, coming up.
What she said, what we played
on the right hand side,
what
right
she
up
said
here
on March 3rd, directly. You know, I'm
the other
urging
side
my colleagues,
speaking
with people on the Hill.
Right
when
it's wrong, I think that's where it is. Yep. See, right where this, if you could see to the right, there's a wall between the highway and the road to get rid of the noise. I used to go for walks right on the other side of that wall, because I used to live right over there to the right. See all them houses over there? I used to be walking around in there. Because up here comes Rowanberry Drive. Well, Montgomery Road, we're getting ready to go under it. See, right on the other side of that wall is where I used to go exercise, go for my walks. We are there we go, under Montgomery Road. See an old house, there's a flag on the bridge.
The proper offer, and then she gets an immunity deal. And know what that means if she takes it? That means she'll be immune from prosecution. That means somebody higher up the chain is going to have to take the fall for her knowing all of this. Now we'll get to more of that. There's our two top stories today. 800-941-SEAN, toll-free telephone number. Look, if you don't use Upside.com, you're basically throwing money down the toilet, because every time you book travel, your plane, your airfare, and your hotel with Upside.com, well, not only are you going to get more options to any travel option you could ever want, and, for example, they find ways to save you money. Well, if I fly an hour earlier, or I stop off at this place, or if I go to a different hotel down the block, oh, I'll even save more money. Every single time you book your travel, I mean, your airfare and hotel with Upside.com, you get a gift card. Every single solitary time. And I'm talking about a small gift card. I'm talking 100, 200, 300 bucks every time. And you're going to save money on every trip.
Boy,
you
it was
pay
so much credit coming down.
You pay not to use Upside.com. Once you use it, you'll
Baltimore
never go back.
County.
Now, Upside.com is the real deal when you're traveling for business or pleasure. Right now, you use it one time, your first time. Just try it out. They're guaranteed to get at least a $200 Amazon gift card. And they're going to save you money just by using the promo code Hannity, right? Real simple, real easy. That's go to Upside.com, promo code Hannity, and you're guaranteed your first trip $200 an Amazon gift card. Why would you go anywhere else? That's insane. That's money in your pocket. Upside.com.
Come on,
Sean Hannity. This is Sean Hannity on Talk Radio 680 WDR.
Man, I just want to get off this highway. Interstate 95. I've had enough of you.
One thing about today's world is you never know when disaster's going to strike. 30
minutes since I left. Still going.
Right?
At least one more. It's going to take me a lot longer to get home.
You know, massive earthquake, tornado, wildfire, God forbid.
Let's go.
You can't get access to your money, your cash, or your valuables. What do you do then? Well, I own a Liberty safe. As a matter of fact, I bought two of them. Well, actually, now I have three. And now I don't have to worry about my bank being closed because I have some cash, some guns, and yes, very important papers right at my Liberty Safe where I need them.
It's finally,
common sense. It's like insurance. And best of all, Liberty Safes are made right here in the USA, and every safe comes with a lifetime warranty against fire or break-ins. Pretty amazing. So get your disaster insurance with a Liberty Safe now on sale. They're going to knock off up to $250 when you buy a Liberty Safe at their website, libertysafeonword.com. Just go to libertysafe.com, promo code Hannity, save up to $250 off. libertysafe.com, promo code Hannity.
No blanker. Good job.
Still traveling on the Interloop 695. As you make your way around from 95 to Security Boulevard, you're going to be on the brakes. Nothing but traffic. No accident activity to contend with there. I-70 westbound.
Did they just say stop and go traffic? Because that's where I'm going.
Getting over to various
between 95 and Security Boulevard, that's where I'm basically at right now.
Activity, Old Frederick Road,
that's where I'm getting on right now. So I'm not going to be happy with that. I was hoping to skip all this crap. I guess I'm not going to get past it.
Del Air Road. Watch for the emergency utility repair at Walter Avenue. Road construction has the right lane taken away.
Come on,
I'm Jim Lavin for Talk Radio.
It seems like no matter how far I go, I'm still on this highway. I have not gotten off 95 yet. I just cannot get done with this part of the trip.
On qualifying new system installations. Reason two.
Here we go, finally.
Systems by Mitsubishi Electric. These systems allow temperature to be controlled room to room, allowing optimal comfort and ultimate in efficiency and energy saving. But the main reason to call Perry Hall
stop and go trap, you son of a...
Experience fair prices. Call 410-256-7285.
I mean, don't these people have a job that lasts longer than 3 o'clock?
At PerryHallHeating.com. There are so many reasons
this
to call
Perry Hall Heating. This is exactly the nightmare that I was hoping wouldn't happen.
What's your reason?
But it's happening.
Perry Hall Heating and Air Conditioning. Serving Northern Baltimore City, Baltimore County, and Harford County for 35 years. Call 410-256-7285. That's 410-256-7285.
Yep,
or
PerryHallHeating.com. Taking 32 or taking 100 over is looking a lot better now.
Builder and home improvements. Karen Staley wrote, we've had contractors, etc. over the years, but the service we've received from AES surpassed
I like how that sign said work area, speed and force. I mean, I'd like to know where you're going to speed because you can't even get going.
Customer service. Maintains an A-plus ready with the Better Business Bureau and is always offered a 5-year free labor warranty, even though Maryland requires only 1 year. You have Tim's personal guarantee with a motto that is the heartbeat of the company. When they're done, you'll be happy. If you're not happy, then they're not done. And folks, Tim's been making Maryland homes great again for over 27 years. Call now for your pre-spring special pricing.
Ridiculous.
25% off any project up to $2,500. 1-800-787-SAVE. 1-800-787-7283. Or 1-800-787-SAVE. Or online at aeshome.us. MHIC number 37105.
The good news? Our business is growing. We have to hire again.
Searching.
Where do we look?
What if we hire the wrong person? Actually, we...
By the way, just so you guys know, I moved and went up this very same road right here in November of 2015. It is now March the 30th, 2017, and they're still working on it. These people are definitely government employees paid by the hour, for sure.
If you're looking to fill one position or 20, find the best candidates fast with ZipRecruiter. Find out why ZipRecruiter has been used by hundreds of thousands of businesses in a variety of industries nationwide. Right now, you can try ZipRecruiter for free. Just go to ZipRecruiter.com/work. That's ZipRecruiter.com/work. ZipRecruiter.com/work.
Live, loud, and local.
Cool.
Sean and Frank.
Here's
show, first time calling.
I should join the commute every morning. Start your day with John and Frank, Maryland's Wake Up Call, weekdays 5 to 9 a.m. on Talk Radio 680 WCBM.
This is the Sean Hannity Show on Talk Radio 680 WCBM.
So I'm watching Adam Schiff. Oh, this, the fact that Devin Nunez's source may have been in the White House. In other words, the White House, okay, they might have known about the leaks, and they said, talk to Devin Nunez, but they weren't the leak. One other thing, the White House, this just broke on Real Quick Politics, is urging the intelligence committees to investigate Evelyn Farkas. Who just said that in the last segment? Oh, I think that was me. All right, Austin Goolsbee next.
Stay tuned for more of the Sean Hannity Show on Talk Radio 680 WCBM.
Every home repair or improvement project should start with a pro you know you can trust. That's why for over 15 years, homeowners have trusted Home Advisor.
Home Advisor is a very easy way to find a home contractor, and for me, it's the only way.
You can use Home Advisor for everything. Your house cleaning, your painting.
Electricians, plumbers, handyman. We've had nothing but fabulous every single time.
Home Advisor is a totally free service that instantly connects you with top-rated pros who have passed criminal and financial background checks.
Knowing that they have had the background checks and that they're vetted absolutely gives me a sense of security.
Plus, Home Advisor's True Cost Guide helps you get a fair price by showing you the cost of similar jobs in your area.
Home Advisor is a total solution to any type of work you would ever want to do around your house.
And best of all, it's completely free. Go to HomeAdvisor.com or download the free app.
Your business is growing, which means now you need to hire more people.
Searching the email.
Where do we start?
ZipRecruiter. Whether you're looking to fill one position or 20, ZipRecruiter makes hiring simple. One click and your job is posted to over 200 job sites. Use ZipRecruiter's dashboard to easily screen and evaluate candidates and find the right hire fast. ZipRecruiter, the fastest way to hire. Now try ZipRecruiter free. Just click the banner now or go to ZipRecruiter.com/talk. That's ZipRecruiter.com/talk.
SH Block can eliminate your tax problems for good. Let our tax professionals get you the fresh start you deserve. Call 410-220-6939 or visit mdtaxattorney.com. SH Block, the local and reliable answer to your IRS problems.
A new travel ban.
We have no other option.
Accusations of wiretap.
This is McCarthyism from Russia.
This is not a drill.
To Obamacare. Understand your world with our news updates.
Understand what's going on.
Talk Radio 680 WCBM.
Wind farm hearings tonight. An officer struck during chase. 50 degrees. These and other stories follow this Fox News Radio update. Good afternoon. It's 4 o'clock.
Stay connected with stimulating talk and breaking news on Talk Radio 680 WCBM, Baltimore, and WCBM.com.
Fox News Radio, I'm Lisa Brady.
This issue is not going to distract us from doing our Russia investigation. If that's the object here, we'll not be successful.
The top Democrat on the House Intelligence Committee, Adam Schiff, moments ago,
still talking about Russia.
White House invitation to view classified information, but also questions about the timing. Published report that two White House staffers were the source of documents viewed
Good
by the Republican
God.
Committee Chairman Devin
cry,
Nunes
cry,
last
cry,
week.
That
cry,
raises profound
on.
Questions about just what the White House is doing.
White House spokesman
really?
John Spicer not commenting on the report about sources, but he says what's important is what's in the documents.
Did something happen in the 2016 election? Did leaks occur? We are not going to engage actively in that kind of leaking that has been a problem.
He also rejects calls for an independent committee, saying there's no need with two congressional panels and the FBI investigating. One of the teenage suspects ordered held without bond in a Maryland rape case has become part of the fuel in the immigration debate. Fox Radio's girl.
Immigration, guys. Okay, commercials, hate commercials. So we're gonna just listen to this dumbass traffic for a few. Man, here we go. Yep, this is why I moved. Right here. You're looking at the reason, one of the big reasons I moved from this place, this area. It's just a cluster. It's only 4 o'clock in the afternoon. It's already a backup already. I mean, this place will be a parking lot at 5, 6 o'clock. It'll be, nobody will move. They'll just move a couple inches. That's it. I just gotta work my way through this so I can get out of it. Guys, still on commercials. God, man, I tell you, I'd be all the way to Hunt Valley, Maryland by now. I'd be all the way on 83 if I hadn't hit these backups. I'd be there already. Practically. This is ridiculous. Yeah, we just went from the Washington Beltway, and now we're on the Baltimore Beltway that circles this city. Boy, the traffic is horrible here. Woodlawn, Maryland, Social Security. That is the official main campus of Social Security for the United States of America. You've got Social Security all over the place, but this one's the main one, the real one, the main campus. I used to work there too. Yep. Security Square Mall is to my left. You cannot see it, but it is a dead mall. Dead, dead, dead. It's like another world, like a nuclear bomb went off in there. The childhood memories of Security Square Mall. What happened to it? Man, now we're going a whopping 15 miles an hour. Yay! We're going 15, man. Yeah, please get out of my way. Thank you. In 15 minutes, that's how long it took me an hour to get where on the way down. I'm about 15 minutes from an hour now, and I'm not even on 83 yet. That's how this backup is really screwing things up. Tag engineering. See, there is a hotel coming up on Windsor Mill Road. Should be. It's probably Dogwood Road, probably, yeah. There's Martin's West. Mom's been in there, I've been in there. Yep, this is Dogwood Road. We're getting ready to go over, but you can't see it. Going over Dogwood Road. The memories. I'm probably going to be as old as Elvis would have been by the time I get out of this backup. Memories. Memories. Alright, maybe the commercials are over.
Specifically about the Trump votes, and C, she's talking about disseminating intelligence information, which could be, I don't know for sure, but could be a violation of the Espionage Act.
See, York, PA, 51, but that's not where I live.
Professor at Chicago School of Economics, former chairman of the Council of Economic Advisors for the Obama administration. He helped give us 13 million more Americans on food stamps, 8 million more poverty, and all right, I'll stop.
The numbers are backwards.
Listen, you should be happy.
Have a date. We've been through this. Your quote number is
over. Really?
No, I'm quoting the end of his term. That's the number that I'm quoting. All right, here's what I want to ask you. Now, the light, you'll agree with me as a professor at Chicago's prestigious.
I made them this promise. We will put our miners back to work. We've already eliminated a devastating anti-coal regulation, but that was just the beginning. Today I'm taking bold action to follow through on that promise. My administration is putting an end to the war on coal. Gonna have clean coal, really clean coal. With today's executive action, I am taking historic steps to lift the restrictions on American energy, to reverse government incursion, and to cancel job-killing regulations. We've already created half a million new jobs in the first two jobs reports of my administration. And if you notice today, Ford, great company, announced massive new spending on three big plants in the state of Michigan, a state which I love very much. Do you remember what happened in Michigan? Remember November 8th? Oh, that was an exciting Michigan evening. And Ford just made that announcement. It's a great announcement. It's a very important announcement. It means jobs, jobs, jobs. We're going to continue to expand energy production, and we will also create more jobs in infrastructure, trucking, and manufacturing. This will allow the EPA to focus on its primary mission of protecting our air and
protecting our water. About to blow past this cocksucker, because we're going to get out of the way.
Together, we are going to start a new energy revolution.
Get all this room in front of you. Go!
American production on American soil. We want to make our goods here instead of shipping them
in
from other countries. All over the world, they ship in, take the Americans' money, go home, take our jobs, take our companies. No longer, folks, no longer. We believe in those really magnificent words. Made in the USA.
All right, so my big question for Austin Goolsbee, who is a professor at the prestigious Booth School of Economics in Chicago, is what's so bad about unleashing America's energy potential? That means coal, and that means fracking and natural gas, and that means drilling, and that means Anwar in the 48 states and off our coast. And we can do it quickly. That means the Dakota pipeline, the XL pipeline. Why did Obama not unleash America's energy potential? We have more natural gas than all the oil and all the Middle East combined, and we could be independent for 200 years.
Okay, Sean, you're all over the place. I need you to focus. There's nothing wrong with having an all-of-the-above energy strategy.
There's a big butt here. Go ahead. Get to the butt.
No, it's not a butt. There's nothing wrong with that. as long as you're doing that in some way that's not polluting the water.
Well, you know, I want dirty air and dirty water.
Undermining a country. There's nothing wrong with that. We should do that. Now, when Donald Trump is talking about he's going to end the war on coal, he doesn't even recognize that when he's saying we're going to open up all the fracking and the price of natural gas is going to go down, that's declaring war on coal. Coal and natural gas are direct competitors. So he's totally confused when he says that.
All right, with all due respect, I think you're missing the broader point, which is, yes, it's an all-of-the-above strategy. B, it's getting rid of the burdensome regulations that have literally stifled energy production in this country and increased our dependence on...
You realize more than doubled our energy production under Obama.
Yeah, okay.
Not
doubled, but we definitely increased it in spite of him, because any increase in production happened on private lands, not federal lands, because he banned the production on federal lands during his presidency. So you got to be accurate.
You're talking about offshore drilling?
No, I'm talking about everything that exploded during his presidency in North Dakota and Texas and Oklahoma.
Maybe Trump's busy with all of his other problems that he's dealing with, like trying to convince his own party to support him on health care or other things. But you recognize he's confused when he says they're going to end the war on coal by...
Okay,
reducing the regulations on natural gas.
I think you're missing the fact that we import such a large percentage of the energy into this country that there's plenty of room for growth in the coal industry, the natural gas industry, and getting our own oil. That we don't have the luxury of waiting. The less dependent we are on foreign oil, guess what? The less dependent we are on getting into Middle Eastern conflicts.
Nothing to do with coal.
Yes, it does.
Burning coal in their car.
I didn't say they were burning it. I'm saying it's a multifaceted approach. I'll give you an example. So years ago, you know, I was a contractor, right?
Yes.
You know, I used to work in people's homes like you, big rich mansions, big professors.
Oh,
and stuff.
We've already been through.
All right.
Orders of magnitude, your house is bigger than mine.
Okay, so that's number one. But I used to do that for a decade of my life. And when I'd go into rich mansions like yours, I would do a lot of work in those places. But I had a van that I purchased that was a former Providence Gas Company van that for the years the Providence Gas Company owned the van. It was run on natural gas and converted back to gasoline when I bought that van for $200, and it was the best $200 I ever spent on my life. Now, the fact that we can somehow slowly and surely transition between oil and gas and fossil fuels to natural gas, which is cleaner burning. Number one, the oil companies can benefit. Everybody can grow their market share. And the only people that are going to see a reduction in market share are going to be those countries that give us oil at artificially high prices because the supply is artificially low because of restrictions your buddy Obama put on the oil and gas industry and the coal industry.
I was like, wow, this must be a good day. I'm agreeing with a lot of what you're saying, but then that whole last part, you just like descended into a spiral of confusion.
Yeah, they see anything Obama, you'll defend even the 13 million more Americans on food stamps.
What you just said Obama did is completely not correct description.
But you won't even acknowledge that Obama accumulated more debt than every president before him combined. Will you admit that?
Are we back
will
on
you,
this
Will
one?
You admit that?
Do we need to just go back through?
Can I just ask you? Will you just
the deficit?
Before we go any further, will you just admit Obama accumulated just about as much debt as every president before him combined?
As George Bush did before that, as Ronald Reagan did before that.
Okay.
Because you're lumping in a whole bunch of inflation, and you're forgetting.
He accumulated more debt. He said
$1 billion in 1880 is not the same thing as $1 billion.
Let's talk about recent history. He accumulated.
Okay.
We had $10 trillion in debt when he took over. Now it's at 20.
As you know, the debt is add up all the deficits. That is what equals the debt.
Uh-huh. You have a hard time. See, that's why I can't have an honest heart-to-heart conversation with you, because anytime
I
mention Obama,
back to accounting.
No, because anytime I mention Obama, your head spins and you bubble and fizz like Alka-Seltzer and water.
Look, let's go back. We could talk about the debt if you want. We could talk about the energy. But I want, the very first thing you said to me was we were going to figure out whether the Republicans were just going to complete their kicking each other in the butt in a big circle over health care. And now they have, the Republicans have the biggest majority in the House they've had in 90 years. I believe they're not going to be able to agree on the budget of themselves. They're going to have a government shutdown because they can't agree with themselves.
Well, I don't think it's going to be on their part. Now, let's see what happens. But I will say this, and I don't want to give you too much intelligence because I know that you still talk to Obama. Have you talked to Obama since he left office?
I haven't seen him since he left office.
When's the last time you talked to Obama?
2 days before he left office.
And did you ever mention my name to Obama?
I'm trying to think. Many people from the administration, high up people, ask me repeatedly, why are you going on Sean Hannity's show? But I don't think that I mentioned you to Obama.
You mean he's never seen you on my show?
I think he has seen me. For sure, many of the high-up people in the White House have seen me.
Well, give me some names. Who are the high-up people that saw you on my show?
David Axelrod has definitely seen me on your show.
Yeah, he doesn't like me. Why does he not like me? I'm a nice guy.
No, I wouldn't say that's true. I'm not saying he especially does like you, but I don't think he especially dislikes you.
Well, I'll take a break, and I'm going to ask you about Evelyn Farkas. I'll give you time to create as much spin as you can in the time we're taking this break. Hey, listen, I have friends at American Financing. Now, they are a national mortgage banker that I highly recommend for you. Now, the good thing is they are salary-based employees. In other words, they're not commission-based. And they're consultants. That means their conversations with you are going to be simple, straightforward. They're not trying to sell you anything. And they're honest. And they're going to listen to your very unique situation, discuss your financial goals, and they will help customize a loan program that is very specific for your needs. And
so that's what that slow up was. Somebody had a fender bender and there was pieces of tires in the road. Great. All right, back to the traffic. Come on, man. Let me get 83 so I can be done with this.
Your historic lows. And by the way, if you don't get locked in now, while you could be paying $500 to $1,000 extra a month, you don't want that to happen. Anyway, right now, you can find your solution. Call American Financing at 800-852-2010. All right? Or go to their website, AmericanFinancing.net, or call 800-852-2010 online, AmericanFinancing.net, or with our buddy coming up, Austin Goolsbee. And then at the bottom of the hour, we'll get to your call straight ahead.
Great for mainstream media, fake news
edit.
This is the Sean Hannity Show.
The Sean Hannity Show on WCBM. Hey, this will sound like a horror story, but for some people, it's reality during tax season. Now, imagine you head to the mailbox after doing your taxes, you reach in, you get rid of all the junk mail, then you pull out the item you've been waiting so long for, only to get a huge shock. In other words, someone's already filed for your return. Now, you probably didn't know that identity thieves could use your personal information to file for your refund or commit other forms of identity theft. In fact, the IRS identified approximately $4.1 billion in suspected identity theft tax refund fraud just in 2016 alone. Thankfully, there's LifeLock. With LifeLock, you have access to a team of U.S.-based specialists who know the steps to take and the calls to make to fix any identity issue. No one can prevent all identity theft or monitor every transaction of every business. Join now. You get 10% off when you visit LifeLock.com/Hannity or just call 1-800-LifeLock. Use the promo code Hannity. LifeLock.com/Hannity. LifeLock.com/Hannity and you save money.
I'm Nick Sobolewski, a select quote agent with a true story that can save you hundreds of dollars a year. A woman named Linda just called. Her husband, Ray, has a $300,000 group life insurance policy
but it's changing jobs.
Let me off of this room. Come on.
Well, I impartially shop the highly rated companies we represent. And Tom Ray, who is 41,
and of course we got cars and all that
cholesterol, a 10-year, $500,000 policy for under $26 a month. That's almost twice the coverage for less than half of what he had paid. If the LifeCore hasn't stopped for your life insurance, you're probably paying too much.
There's Pennsylvania in front of me, so they're going the same way. They're going the whole way, I'm sure.
9393. That's 1-800.
Pennsylvania tags.
9393. 1-800-238-9393. Or go to selectquote.com. We shop. You save. Get full details of the example policy. Selectquote.com/commercials. Your price can vary depending on your health, issue, and company, and other factors. Not available in all states.
It's time to contact one of the area's top-rated lawn care services for a beautiful lawn this year. American Lawn and Tree Specialists, with over 23 years of experience, provide Central Maryland with an organic-based lawn care program.
Man, I am
making
still
your grass the greenest on the block. Start your lawn care the right way.
The Baltimore Beltway.
American Lawn and Tree Specialists train professionals
in organic-based
lawn care programs. Taking your lawn by activating the soil, helping to eliminate unsightly weeds, promoting healthy turf from the ground up. Also enhance your landscape with a comprehensive ornamental tree and shrub program
that
to include
close
deep root fertilization and insect and disease protection. For a limited time only,
got that on
receive
video
half
too
off your first lawn care application when you purchase the basic lawn care program. Call American Lawn
right now,
and
I'm
Tree
just using
Specialist
a,
today.
I'm just using a regular old cell phone right now with a little holder on my mirror, but I'm going to get one of those dash cams because you really should video. Deck out your vehicle with a, if you can afford it, do a back, you know, a video on the back and a video on the front, but at least one on the front. Because people like to make up a bunch of crap when they have an accident. At least when you have video of it, you're set. Now we're on 83. See how it's backing up, going back to the Beltway on the left side over here. Because they're going to this Beltway, usually going north. Once we get past Hunt Valley, we are done. It's just open wide and go, but we'll see.
You know, all this is only a phone call away. Call 800-501-6000. Contact this.
We are headed home. That's why I moved from this place. Pennsylvania is so much more relaxing. I mean, it really is. It's so laid back and relaxing up here. It's great. You love it. You'd love it if you were here.
Carefully. If you owe over $10,000 in back taxes or have unfiled tax returns, U.S. Tax Shield can help you take back control. The IRS can seize your bank accounts, garnish your paycheck, close your business,
North,
and file
North
criminal
Pennsylvania
charges. Our team of tax attorneys can stop collections and get you protected. U.S. Tax Shield offers a price protection guarantee vault to get you protected today. U.S. Tax Shield is A-plus rated with the PBB, so call 800-519-7796. U.S. Tax Shield, 800-519-7796.
Do you have an uneasy feeling that your loved one may no longer
just think, at an appointment that lasted about 20-25 minutes, but I spent 2.5 hours driving to do the appointment. Good
guy. Exploring that area is where quality care is second only to making you and your loved one part of our family. Call 301-829-6050 or visit LorianMountAire.com.
Hey, you're listening to the Sean Hannity Show right here on Talk Radio 680 WCBM.
Continue with Austin Goldsby, a prestigious professor at Chicago's Booth School of Economics. Are you ever going to let me come and talk to your class?
I would love that. When are you going to come? What do you want
I was just in Chicago, and I didn't have time to get in touch with you because I was in and out.
You didn't call? You came here and you didn't even call?
No, but the last time I did it, I took you and your lovely bride out to dinner, and I had a great time because of her.
We did have a good time.
It was a lot of fun. Well, you do owe me a hot dog.
I owe you dinner. I know.
Listen, I bought you a steak and expensive wine. You can just buy me a hot dog, a Chicago dog, the best one in town, and I'll be happy.
Oh, that's what I'm planning to do. Do you like french fries?
Yeah, but I don't eat them because I'm on a diet.
You're going to get some.
Do you eat french fries? Everybody, how could you not like french fries? You have to be ridiculous not to like.
No, no, I like french fries, but I'm just connoting the style of restaurant that we are going to go to is going to be proportional to the square footage in our houses.
You don't have any idea where I live. You have no idea what my square footage is about. What if I lived in a New York apartment? You don't even know where I live.
I would be very surprised. I know you live on Long Island.
Yeah, I think I told you that.
You told me that.
Yeah.
Why did I do that? And you got a family of tennis players, so they got to have some space over there.
Yeah, there's a little space there, but I admit, but I drive an hour and 15 minutes to get home every day, so I can get out of this city and the disgusting smell of the city.
What happened to the thing that you were going to move to Texas? I got a lot of my parents' friends wanted you to come over there.
Well, I would love to. Well, do you understand I pay a 10% state of New York income tax?
I know, that's what you said.
If I die in New York,
you weren't going to stay there.
Yeah, I know, but my job is here, so I can't leave until my job is over. I gotta help now undo the mess that your guy created after 8 years, and it's a full-time job.
Wait, he wasn't in New York City. What are you talking about? You chose...
Well, he ruined the whole country, and not just New York.
It's almost like you personally are proving my point that it's not primarily about taxes. It's about human capital and being aware that
I think you are
that leads to economic growth.
This is what we need to do. You need to arrange a sit-down with me and Obama and you. And let's see if we can't. You think he'd ever sit down and have a beer? Because he once said that he'd have a beer with me. And another time he said that he's going to send some guy to tear me up. He made a physical threat against my life. Did you know that?
I really did not know that.
You want to hear it? Yeah, listen.
That was pretty good. I might have to put Mr. Burgess on Fox News. I'll put Mr. Burgess up against Sean Hannity. Go tear him up.
Tear him up? That was a threat to my physical person. And then he said at another point, I'm always up for a beer.
With respect to Sean Hannity, I didn't know that he had invited me for a beer. I will take that under advisement. Generally, his opinion of me does not seem to be very high, but I'm always good for a beer.
Right?
I will supply the beer for that one.
All right. Well, Austin, good to talk to you. It's very hard for us to have any other conversation on politics because you're always wrong, but I still like you. Thanks for being with us.
We always have a good time, even if we don't always agree.
When I tell your better half I said hello and that you owe me a hot dog. All right, when we come back, your call's 800-941-SHAWN.
So this traffic update brought to you by the Silverado Gun Show. Right now, we're looking at the inner loop of the Beltway, 695. Between Washington Boulevard and Security
it
Boulevard.
It is taking so long to get out.
Also on the inner loop, 695 at Green Spring Avenue. Accident activity there.
Yep, that's that accident that I went by.
And, of course, the first responders on scene from Reisterstown Road. The left shoulder's taken away. Three cars involved. Inner loop 695 between 8 to 23 to JFX and getting over to the Perry Parkway. You can be on the brakes as well. Join us for the Silverado Gun Show at the Frederick County Fairgrounds this Saturday and Sunday. Stop by the best gun show in Maryland. It's fun for the entire family. See you at the Silverado Gun Show this weekend at the Frederick County Fairgrounds. I'm Jim Lavin on AM 680 WCBM. Clouds have already rolled in, and we're going to keep the clouds in the forecast here through the afternoon. 73 showers.
Clouds have rolled in. They've been here. It's been cloudy all day.
Thunderstorms have been best tomorrow. Some of the rain could be heavy. High 60. Clouds on tap for Saturday. High 62. Richard Weather at the Weather Channel for Talk Radio 680.
Man, it was so easy. It was so easy to get down there. I mean, I'm coming home this horrible. I'm still not home yet.
Talk Radio 680 WCBM and WCBM.com. Good afternoon. I'm Michael Filippelli in the 680 WCBM Maryland News Center with the news at 4:31. North Carolina's rollback of the state's bathroom bill doesn't satisfy at least one member of Bruce Springsteen's band, which canceled the concert last year over the law that limits LGBT protections. Guitarist Miami Steve Van Zandt tweeted today that it ain't over until the LGBT community and the ACLU says it's over. The White House has invited the heads of congressional intelligence committees.
Yeah, I'm not talking about the actual whatever the bill is we're talking about. I'm just talking about, like, we really care.
Security Council.
White House spokesman Sean
how
Spicer
Bruce Springsteen feels. Who cares?
A new survey shows
just like,
most
what's
Americans
her name?
Disapprove of
I
President
can't think
Trump's
her name now because she's irrelevant now.
They're more positive about how he's handling the economy.
What the hell's her name?
Associated Press, NORC, Center for Public Affairs Research, amid the collapse of the GOP's health care overhaul. The news is brought to you by
the fact that I can't think of her name when she's an actress.
Your home fast and
Meryl Streep.
Yes, your home
it's because she's irrelevant. Her career has been over for a long time. Who cares what you think or anybody else? Celebrities think. Nobody cares.
Reporting at 4:32, I'm Michael Filippelli. That's a WCBM News. Hi, Sean Casey. If you've had your home previously listed and it didn't sell, then here's why it's so important to call my real estate agent, Vinny Steele, of Remax Components. The fact is, Vinny's homes are more likely to sell and not fit. Vinny sells homes nearly two times faster than the average agent, and for 5% more money on average. Vinny is so confident your home is going to sell that if your home doesn't sell, he will buy it at a price acceptable to you. That's right, guaranteed. Get this, Gail needed to downsize after all the kids had grown and moved out. She reached out to Vinny using his explosive buyers and waiting system.
Man, it's like I'm never going to. It was so much quicker to get here.
And negotiated with the buyer.
But at least we're on 83 now. The backups should be gone now.
Don't just hire any realtor to negotiate one of your equity with long lead times to sell. Vinny is waiting to hear from you. So call today 1-800-834-VINNY. 1-800-834-VINNY. Or go to VinnyHasTheBuyers.com. That's VinnyHasTheBuyers.com.
From the Fox Business Network, financial and energy stocks leading to a rally on Wall Street today with the Dow closing up 69 points. And tech titans leading the Nasdaq for a record close, the 21st time this year, closing up 17 points. The Labor Department reporting that the number of people filing for unemployment benefits climbed by 3,000 last week to 258,000. Sign that the U.S. jobs market is healthy. Applications have remained below 300,000 for 108 weeks. Such a low level
is a
jobs and also means that those who are laid off may not be seeking unemployment assistance as often as in the past. And
Headed out to the hills. Yeehaw!
Recently imposed U.S. ban on electronic devices by offering its business class passengers a laptop loan service. Qatar, the only airline to offer passengers a replacement laptop on all of its flights to the United States. With the Fox Business Report, I'm Hillary Barsky. Are you taking Viagra for ED? Now you can get Sildenafil, the active ingredient in Viagra. Engineered 20 milligrams for $2 per tablet.
This guy up here is holding up everything. Car up above, two cars, this is the head of the car in front of him. It's just holding up everybody. I've got a line behind me.
Sean Hannity on Talk Radio 680 WCBM.
Finally.
Now till the top of the hour, top two stories today. Republicans, you need to get your act together. End of sentence. This is ridiculous.
By the way, that's that same vehicle that I said had Pennsylvania tags all the way back in the Baltimore Beltway.
With the health care bill.
That's in front.
And at the end of the day, it may end up being one of
same
the best favors they did to the Republican leadership. It's not the president's fault either. The president, I think, it's sort of like he's being told information about the Senate parliamentarian that isn't true. About reconciliation, about the bird rule, about, you know, all of these issues, closure. There's a way to do this. It was so frustrating the 8 years in, and we haven't resolved this issue.
I'm going to get over and let Mr. Blue call go.
Top story today is, of course,
so they can go on through because they're really hauling the mail.
Here
to go. Hauling the mail.
Let's go to the original statement she made on Liberal Joe when she said the following, where she admits surveillance took place, unmasking took place, and talked about leaking intelligence.
See, it's all PA tags now, mostly.
And,
backwards facing the people on the Hill. It was more actually aimed at telling the Hill people, get as much information as you can, get as much intelligence as you can before President Obama leaves the administration.
Never heard of this woman before, but she has an awesome name, Evelyn Farkas. She's going to be famous. It's her name, Farkas. Meet the Farkas. Dick Farkas, Evelyn Farkas, the Farkas. Where are you going? Going over to Farkas. Farkas's house. Seeing Farkas. How the hell are you doing there, Farkas? Doing great, pal.
So then I had talked to some of my former colleagues, and I knew that they were
trying to help Farkas
get information to
the Hill. What a Farkas.
A lot going on today. Yeah, Mark, that's why you don't believe it. Thanks, Doc. What are you worried?
She's talking about leaking intelligence. You know, now she's backing it off today, and my name was brought up on CNBC in an interview with her. Let's listen to what she said.
And that the Trump folks, if they found out how we knew what we knew about the Trump staff is dealing with the Russians, that they would try to compromise those sources and methods, meaning we no longer have access to that intelligence.
See red lights over here.
I wanted you to just explain what you meant by that, and in particular when you talk about if they found out how we knew. What do you mean by how they how we knew?
Well, what I was getting at, the fact that we were having now a transition of power from the Obama administration to the Trump administration. And if indeed there was an investigation ongoing, if indeed there was information that the Obama administration had about Russian interference and possible American involvement, I wanted to make sure that Congress knew about it, that Congress had all that information. So I simply was referring, because we were having a conversation about concern in Washington about what was going on with regard to Russian actions and potential American involvement. And so I was urging my former colleagues I worked on the Hill in the Senate years ago to make sure that they were reaching out to the White House to get all the information they could, because I was afraid that somehow there might be a cover-up if there was something behind the allegations.
But you actually said, I knew that there was more. I became very worried because not enough was coming out into the open, and I knew that there was more, and then you actually then said that's why you have all the leaking to make sure we get it out. I mean, people are accusing you, Evelyn, of admitting that there was surveillance, admitting that there was unmasking, and urging people, or at least saying that intelligence leaking, which could be a fake, is the way that it should get out. And you weren't even part of the government at that point.
I was referring to the motivation, because there's been a lot of discussion in the media about why are people leaking. And
why are people leaking?
Trying to, but in a very short
fashion. Maybe because they have to go to the bathroom. That's
the
why.
That
they're leaking.
That people were leaking because they were afraid of a cover-up. I do
not.
No,
they were leaking.
Absolutely do not.
Because they had a lot of coffee in the morning.
You know, it's against the law. What I was doing was explaining, though, why people might be motivated to do that. And I did not have any insider information myself, but I knew based on what was coming out in the press from these leaks and from official sources, that were quoting people, that my government probably has a pretty good sense of what the Russians did, because we have good intelligence on Russia.
That's not even good spin. I mean, Rick Hunter can do better than that for them. And, you know, as I said yesterday on the program,
Evelyn Farkas, this is a Sean Hannity alert. If I were you, we're not accusing you of committing any crime or knowing or having knowledge about surveillance, unmasking, or any type of intelligence leak, but just for the safety and security, I'd get a lawyer next time before you go on television. Just a thought. Just a thought. Evelyn Farkas, no ability. It's ridiculous.
But this is huge. We're going to have more on this tonight on Hannity 10 Eastern. We're going to have some of this with our buddy Dr. Jonathan Gillum coming up at the top of the hour. That's also coming up. All right, let's get to our busy phones. Let us say hi to Tom and Charleston in South Carolina. What's up? How are you, Tom? Glad you called.
All right, how you doing? How you doing, man? I'm good, man. How are you?
Straight up ahead is that black vehicle that came all the way from the Baltimore Beltway.
Standing up and talking out, man. It's like discouraging listening to some of the mainstream media and the news that's out. And driving home from work, I'll listen to you turn you on the radio, and it's like just refreshing and encouraging to hear that you're actually talking about the things that should be talking about.
Well, I really appreciate it, and I can't do this without you. I honestly do feel, in terms of the media, I feel like I'm an island unto myself at this point in history. There's no doubt about it. But I'm going to be here because I know that we're on the right spot.
It's been well over an hour. It took only an hour to get down there. There, past that car.
But it's taken me 90
minutes so far. I'm still not home. So I'm already half an hour over what it took to get down there.
And Rush, that at least are out there talking about it and keeping it out there, man. It's like you're not afraid to speak up about it and you speak out.
I only have one agenda. My agenda is that we get the country in the right position. That's my agenda. That we now stop America's precipitous decline. My agenda is that Americans get back to work. Americans get back in the home buying business. That Americans get back in the saving business. That Americans have a better future for their kids and grandkids. That's it. You want to know my? It's not a political agenda in the sense that I don't care who's right. I'm going to support them. And I have no compunctions about calling out anybody that's wrong. And right now,
that's the way it should be. I'm sorry, I didn't mean to interrupt. That's right. The way it should be, Sean. It's just disgusting when I see really what the direction of the country's going with the media kind of stifling things and just have, they have a big agenda and it's just so wrong. And it's like, you know, the future of our kids really, you know, is out there. And I think we've got a lot to do with, you know, the success of Trump.
Now we got to get the agenda. Well, Trump's doing all the things he can do on his own, but he doesn't run the legislative branch. They need to get their job done. And I'm getting very impatient. After 8 years, they can't build a freaking consensus bill. It's ridiculous. I have no more patience for it, Tom. It's just not right. The American people deserve better service than this. Anyway, let's go to... All right, let's say I got a Jim in Sarasota, Florida, Southwest Florida. What's going on, Jim? How are you, sir?
Good afternoon, Sean. How are you?
I'm good, sir. What's going on?
Great talking to you. Hey, you know, I'm real concerned. I mean, this morning, I trust Trump 100%. I think he's doing a great job. It really bothers me what happened with the healthcare situation. I tend to believe that there was a three-phase approach. And my point is that had the economy gotten better and they passed the original bill and then they went on to tax reform and the economy's getting better, he would have gotten consensus from 60 votes. And then...
No, he's never getting 60 votes in Chuck Schumer's Senate. I don't think.
Okay. Well, my concern is between this morning that the Freedom Caucus is better in playing them all. And what that kind of tells me is that his budget, his agenda is 350 maybe shipbuilding of the Navy. Is gonna, the Freedom Caucus is maybe going to get obstruct based on if the moves don't align. And that really concerns me because that even some of the funding for the wall, the $3 billion that's out there in the budget, if they don't approve that, if they don't play ball with him, then he's going to really have a tough time governing, don't you think? I mean, aren't you concerned?
I'm very concerned. Why do you think I started out so angry tonight? I think he's been misserved. I don't think he's been served well here. And as much as, you know, he has been there only a couple of months. But these Republicans have been there talking about repealing, replacing Obamacare for 7 and 8 years. And the fact that they didn't build consensus. Here's the problem. He's the executive branch. And I'm sure that somebody's stoking this fire and telling him the Freedom Caucus, no, because they didn't the bill the right
off the
way.
Highway.
And in other words, if you don't show the Freedom Caucus, the study group, the Tuesday
this video
group, the
will show
group,
the
Saturday
exact amount
group,
of time.
The
I mean, it's been a long
if
time.
If you don't show them the bill ahead of time,
so when I put it all together, whenever that time comes down to, that's how long it took to get back.
Then the day after it's released, there's a huge fight going on. Then I'm sorry, that to me is a leadership mistake.
We are hitting a town called Maryland 9, because it's on the Maryland 9. We're like 30 miles north of, we went way up north. about to cross into Pittsburgh, not Pittsburgh, into Shrewsbury, PA, and New Freedom, PA. Yep, going to cross into Pennsylvania in a second. Yep, here we go, getting ready to cross in. And little teeny sign on this road, welcome to Pennsylvania. We're in Pennsylvania now.
To celebrate, they're giving you a free business startup kit.
Yep, still this drive is not done. 15-20 minute appointment, all this drive. Oh my gosh. Might not be a good idea to make it this late this time. Make your appointment like 1 o'clock in the afternoon so that you can get down there with no traffic and leave with no traffic. That's probably what I'll do. This 2:45 thing didn't work. Too much traffic coming back. Because I still have to pick the card up. I have to pick up my identification. Goodness, oh my God, just thank you. I'm tired of driving. Thank you. just about home. This is my development, where I live. So I'm gonna go right in there. Yay! Gotta go slow, there may be kids. Yep, my house is still there. That's fans. Okay, I'm gonna back in to my home. Boy, that's a long drive. God, man, that's got to be one of the longest drives home ever in history. One minute you're Washington Beltway, next minute you're in Pennsylvania. There you go. So, back in Shrewsbury, PA, in the same driveway. Oh, I didn't get the, let me get the mileage off. Okay. The ending mileage, the beginning mileage was 55,886 miles. The ending mileage is 56,020 miles. And there you have it. And it's 4:54 in the, whatever. 4:54 in the afternoon. And when I left, it was 12:20. And it's 4:54 in the afternoon now. So anyway, back home. Trip to the DC Beltway and suburbs and to get the identification, and I'm back. So we'll see you on the next video. Latest. All right, here's where I had to go to get my card for security clearance. 5601 Sunnyside Avenue, Beltsville, Maryland. 20705. Okay, here it is. See, look, here's how far it was. I came all the way down. I had to go all the way back. Coming down took an hour. Going back took close to 2 hours. Traffic. I actually had the entire trip back on video, so I'm going to make a second video out of the first video, and just the whole trip back will be on there, and all the complaining about traffic. But anyway, here's where. This is where you can go, see? This is where you go to get it. Right there. Do the overhead. And I was there 6 years ago, and I parked in the same area. See, I went in through these front doors. And then you go this way, and then you go this way, and it's somewhere back in here. Yeah. You go there, and then you make lefts, and the room is in here somewhere. But 2011, I parked right here, but what I didn't realize is these are all empty because they're for some kind of van, such and such, whatever, some kind of transportation thing. So these are all empty, so 6 years ago, I could have gotten tickets. So I saw that this year and parked right here. I was sitting right in this spot right here, and I walked. I did not do the sidewalk. I cut across the grass, cut across here, and then went in. And went right in here and got my stuffs. And I ate my foods. This place is awesome right here. I'm going to right. Yaya's, Yaya's Kitchen. That is some awesome food there. They got so many gyros, it's unbelievable. But I went right in there and I parked right here. And went in here and ate. And I went home, the trip home from here, I went down here, came down here, got on the Capitol Beltway here, got on 95 right here, and then the adventure began because I got about, where did I get? Right up here, just past 198. Then the backup started, and it just kept going. And it just kept going backups all the way. This is a star right here because I used to live right there. Where I wouldn't bury goodbye, is it on? But that's not where I live. I lived right here on Road. Look. Wonder if the picture is old or new. It says 2017, yes, and my car's gone. For the longest time, like this was my parking spot here, and I had another one over here. Not the clearest picture, but this was my house here, and then, I don't know, I guess that's the new people there. That's the dude that I lived in the end over here, and that's their other one. But it's been a while, I guess the same people live there. Anyway, that's what it did. I went all that way, and just backups after backups. This place was really close when I lived right here. I'd just go, whoosh. But instead now I live all the way up there. Anyway, that's it. That was the trip.